you, O Lord, pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips,
and our mouths shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father,
and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Come, let us adore him. Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving, go into his courts with praise, give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his faithfulness endures from age to age. The Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Come, let us adore him. Psalm 31. In you, O Lord, have I taken refuge. Let me never be put to shame. Deliver me in your righteousness.
Incline your ear to me. Make haste to deliver me.
Be my strong rock, a castle to keep me safe, for you are my crag and my stronghold. For the sake of your name, lead me and guide me.
Take me out of the net that I have secretly set for me. For you are my tower of strength.
Into your hands I commend my spirit. For you have redeemed me, O Lord, O God of truth.
I hate those who cling to worthless idols. And I put my trust in the Lord.
I will rejoice and be glad because of your mercy. For you have seen my affliction and know my distress.
You have not shut me out in the power of the enemy. You have set my feet in an open place.
Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eye is consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly.
For my life is wasted with grief, and my beard is sighing. My strength fails me because of affliction, and my bones are consumed.
I have become a reproach to all my enemies and even to my neighbors. A dismay to those of my acquaintance. When they see me in the street, they avoid me.
I am forgotten like a dead man at home. I am as useless as a broken pot.
For I have heard the whispering of the crowd, tears all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life.
But as for me, I have trusted in you, O Lord. I have said, you are my God.
My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me.
Make your face shine upon the servant.
Lord, let me not be ashamed for having called upon you. Rather, let the wicked be put to shame. Let them be silent in the grave.
Let the lying lips be silent which speak against the righteous. Also, ye disdainfully and with contempt.
How great is your goodness, O Lord, which you have laid up for those who fear you. Which you have done in the sight of all for those who put their trust in you.
You hide them in the covert of your presence from those who slander them.
besieged city.
Yet I said, my alarm, I have been cut off from the sight of your eyes. Nevertheless, you heard the sound of my entreaty when I cried out to you.
Love the Lord, all you who worship him. The Lord protects the faithful, but repays to the full those who act haughtily.
Be strong, let your heart take courage. All you who wait for the Lord.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. A song of God's blessing. God be gracious to us and bless us, and make his face to shine upon us, that your way be known upon earth, your saving power among all nations. Let the peoples praise you, O God, let all the peoples praise you. O let the nations rejoice and be glad, for you will judge the peoples righteously and govern the nations upon earth. Let the peoples praise you, O God. Let all the peoples praise you. Then shall the earth bring forth her increase, and God, our own God, will bless us. God will bless us, and all the ends of the earth shall fear him. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Letter to the Ephesians, 6th chapter, beginning with the first verse. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise, so that it may be well with you, and you may live long on the earth. And fathers, do not
A song of Christ's glory. Beloved, let us love one another, for God is love. Everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, for God is love. In this, the love of God was revealed among us, that God sent his only Son into the world, so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we love God, but that he loved us, and has sent his Son to be an expiation for our sins. Beloved, since God loved us so much, we ought also to love one another. For if we love one another, God abides in us, and God's love will be perfected in us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again and judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Show us your mercy, O Lord,
and grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
Almighty God, whose Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, is the light of the world, grant that your people, illumined by your word and sacraments, may shine with the radiance of Christ's glory, that he may be known, worshipped, and obeyed to the ends of the earth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Almighty God, whose most dear Son went not up to joy, but first he suffered pain, and entered not into glory before he was crucified, mercifully grant that we, walking in the way of the cross, may find it none other than the way of life and peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you stretched out your arms of love on the hardwood of the cross that everyone might come within the reach of your saving embrace. So clothe us in your Spirit that we, reaching forth our hands in love, may bring those who do not know you to the knowledge and love of you, for the honor of your name.
Amen.
Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you, and you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.